First of all, I would like to thank you, Dr. Professor, for giving me this opportunity. I work under the Dr. Sathya Vijay and Dr. Vijay for my higher knowledge. So this is my skull basis recording. This whole presentation is there in this website. You can watch anytime. I will update YouTube channel. You can access almost 400-500 videos of Sathya Vijay and various subjects. Okay, coming to our topic now, I am directly going to the cochlear part. So here, the center of the round window and the center of the oval window and helicoptrim, and these three are in a 90-degree triangle. This is the first part. And next is the center of the roughly corresponds to the center of the oval window, roughly corresponds to the groove of the tensor tympani. So this tensor tympani cochleostomy and this base of the GSPN roughly corresponds to the superior third cochleostomy. I will explain it. These two. So gradually we go. This is oval window, this is round window. Let us make it as a flush shape, and this is antero superior, this is antero inferior, postero superior, postero inferior. And first is the round window insertion. We have to make round window insertion at antero inferior quadrant. See, round window insertion, antero inferior quadrant. Okay, when we are unable to pass through the antero inferior quadrant due to prominent distalphenic weight, we have to make marginal cochleostomy. Marginal cochleostomy means we have to build the margin of the crista finister. This whole red thing is the crista finister. I will explain that in an elaborate manner later. So this is marginal cochleostomy. Next, antero inferior cochleostomy. This is the most advocated cochleostomy. So antero superior, antero inferior, and we are making cochleostomy antero inferior in the crista finister. This is also in the crista finister. Next, inferior cochleostomy. So antero inferior, we are making inferior, that is inferior cochleostomy, this one. This one is inferior cochleostomy. Dr. Sathya Vijay advocates this inferior cochleostomy because it is a direct trajectory to the scalar tympani. So he always do inferior cochleostomy, Dr. Sathya Vijay. And this is the superior cochleostomy. And for superior, I am doing superior cochleostomy. One should not do the superior cochleostomy. We will injure the osseous spinal canal. That I will explain later. So one should not do superior cochleostomy. And next is scalar vestibular cochleostomy. Sir, any other pointer?
This
confusion.
Yeah,
I think
that's
the
only one. Use it carefully.
That's all.
That's
the front course. This scalar vestibular cochleostomy. That means we have to make a cochleostomy between the oval window and round window. That is scalar vestibular cochleostomy. The middle term cochleostomy. That is 1 or 2 mm, just only 1 or 2 mm, you should not cross more than that. 2 mm, 1 or 2 mm, anterior to the oval window, that is middle term cochleostomy. So there is a term called perseus triangle, that is called dangerous triangle. There, dangerous, perseus triangle. The upper portal is formed by the horizontal part of the fascia, lower portal by the Jacobson nerve, posterior portal by the anterior portal of the oval window. So the middle term cochleostomy, you should not go anteriorly. The reason is this labyrinthine part of the fascia nerve in that triangle. So you should not do more than 2 mm in the middle term cochleostomy. This one, osseous spinal canal, is starting from posterior superior and When you are doing this superior copulostomy, you will insert this arches parallel. It goes down and that is arches parallel. The below is keratin type, above is scala. Yes. This red one is the distal cingulate, style extender. So, this is what you are seeing to the superior copulostomy, you are seeing the arches parallel. So, when you are seeing basal turn, middle turn, and apical turn. This pipelinea are needed to this scala tibia. See here also, in the middle turn. So, we have our aim is to insert in this scala tibia. Suppose if you mistakenly hit the superior copulostomy and inserted into the scala vestibular, then stimulate this, you have to increase the threshold. Not only this, you can stimulate this one also. So the middle with the scala vestibular insertion, you can insert, you can stimulate this spiral ganglion middle turn also with the increase of the threshold. So always the preferable choice is scala tibiae. Next. This superior scala vestibular copulostomy with the inclination of the microscope, you can appreciate the inferior part of the arches parallel. So, to summarize this copulostomy, again, this is anterosuperior quadrant and inferior quadrant, posterosuperior quadrant, posterior quadrant. So, this is anteroinferior copulostomy. Inferior copulostomy. Superior copulostomy, one should not. Scala vestibular copulostomy, that I will explain when we are moving. This is middle turn copulostomy. This is at the root of the GS cavity is superior turn copulostomy. This has to be done to the middle cranial fossa. So again, this is GSP and this is groove of encephalitis. If you do the middle cranial fossa approach, if you do the copulostomy at the root of the GSP, it goes to the superior turn. Again, when you do it in the groove of this tensor tympani also, it goes to the superior turn copulostomy. So, through the middle ear approach, you can approach the superior turn copulostomy in the groove of the tensor tympani. Through the middle cranial fossa, especially in cholecystic matrices, or high jugular curve where you cannot appreciate any road video, then you have a choice of middle turn. Middle cranial fossa, superior turn copulostomy. Superior turn copulostomy. Next, three hours. This anterior-inferior copulostomy and inferior copulostomy, if you follow in this line, this is scala tympanate film. And if you follow this scala vestibular copulostomy and superior copulostomy, if you follow this in the lap of superior scala tympani, that includes the scala vestibular. Similarly, middle turn copulostomy, and if you follow this in the lap of scala vestibular, it becomes the middle turn copulostomy. So there are so many details of this. What is the chronological order we are doing? This is there. In the evening I will explain these things in the build of the lecture. First we have to tell the basal turn of the past descendants, and then if we can't identify that, then unsuccessful, then we have to go to the scala vestibular. So these are the split areas. How we have to insert these split areas in this various copulostomies. We will explain in the evening. The third lecture is that. Again, same retrograde manner from superior to basal turn. Similarly, split areas. So, carotid relation to cochlea. This is very important. One should be sculpted surgeon to do cochlear implant. Again, one should be cochlear implant surgeon to do sculpted. The pre-cochlear carotid. The intratemporal carotid is divided into pre-cochlear carotid, that is the half general part of the intratemporal carotid and the vertical part of the intratemporal carotid and half general part of the intratemporal carotid. This is called vitreous carotid. This is called pre-cochlear carotid. So it is just in front to the cochlea. So both the facial nerve and intratemporal carotid both have the same structures. Vertical, vertical. Argent, argent. Both have the same structures. Vertical, vertical. In this axis. Pre-cochlear. Parts of the cochlea. What are the parts of the cochlea? There, pars inferior, pars ascendens, pars superior, pars descendens. One, pars inferior, pars ascendens, three. Pars superior, this is pars inferior. Similarly, like duodenum, same parts are there. So both have same parts, pars. So why we need to know these parts? This part ascendens is associated with pre-cochlear carotid. I will show you in the next diagram. This part superior is associated with the laryngeal part of the facial. So when you post-operative, when you get your facial twitchings, you have to switch off these electrodes. Part superior electrodes. So this is scalar tympani. This is both thing is basal term scalar tympani. So scalar tympani is very adjacent to vertical part of the carotid. So only protecting layer is outer wall of the cochlea. So when you are drilling the cochlea, you should never reach outer wall of the cochlea when you reach the scalar ascendens. Never, never. From here to here it is scalar part ascendens. Vertical part of the carotid. See, this carotid comes up to supratemporal pieces also. It almost sometimes clearly replicated pieces, analysis, yes. So always you have to keep in your back of mind all the variations of any structures in the region. So it is actually it should be below especially. Now in this case, it extended into supratemporal pieces also. So there are so many instances where the electrode passed into the carotid canal. See, in adult, this carotid, pre-cochlear carotid is 7 mm. From over window, this is 7 mm. This is Dr. Sri Ramakrishna's work. So, please think about the children. It is even less. So you have to be very careful when doing cochleostomies in difficult cases. So you have to be very careful. Your birth should not slip. You have to be first you make a notch, then only you give pressure. Pars superior. This is middle cranial fossa pilosis. See, angle between the superior semicircular canal and GSPN is inclinated canal. The angle between the laryngeal part of the facial nerve and the GSP is cochlea, that is far superior of basal nerve. See, this is the laryngeal part of the facial nerve. This is Geno, first Geno, GSP. So, far superior and it is very near to laryngeal part of the facial nerve. So, in the post-operative, when you get a facial twitchings, you have to switch off these electrodes. Accordingly, you have to do AVD also. See the close relation. Only outer wall of the cochlea is protecting carotid from our lumps. Rates of ossifications. There are several grades of ossification. I will explain this in the evening. 1A, 1B ossification, post-meningeal diseases, several ossification diseases. Ossification further goes up to ascendants. Whole skeletal grades. Another grade 3B, I will explain in a little bit. Grade 4, totally aspirated. So, pericious triangle, pericious triangle. Superior formed by the Argent part of the facial, inferior by the Jacobson, posterior by the posterior. Importance is labyrinthine part of the facial. So, this is the wall. This is actually in the previous literature when I drawn this, it is mentioned as Minotaur. And I am doing in sections, I came to know that it is superior turn, that is path superior. So I will explain the further diagrams. Already explained. This is fused disc. I will explain that one. This fused disc almost touches the crista semilunans. I will explain that. So here, this third part, no electrode goes up into the superior turn. All the companies go up to middle turn only. So this is in the pars inferior, this is in the pars ascendens, this is in the pars superior, this is in the pars descendens. And little bit into the, this also comes in the middle turn and this also comes in the middle turn. So this corresponding to your record. This is fine. Over into part of the tissue of the job. This is the narrow point. Level 10 part of the patient. This I have done the cadaver dissection. This is the pericytic. This is level 10 part of the patient. See how close it is. This is over. So, is the round window is really round? Answer is no. This is our Indian author, Professor Sangla, has presented this one. Round window, different shapes. Oval, round, triangular, comma, quadrangular, pier. So many. And this is foreign literature. See how many shapes are there. It is not actually round. Sometimes it is round, sometimes not. So Professor Proctor, long back in 1960s itself, he presented like this. He has presented more than 30 pages only about all different data. There are so many names he has mentioned. Now coming to our topic, round window feature, and this has to be discussed accordingly in this manner. So this is the round window line. That is entry point of round window. This is the round window membrane. This is scalar entry. So we have to study the structures outside the round window like it. That means what are the structures outside the round window? Round window like a variations and gradient. And very round window like a areas and important areas and round window membrane and hoop region. This round window has to be studied in this 5 regions. Round window like a normal parts. See in the old literature when there is no endoscopic. This is from Professor Clark Pepper. And the inferior operculum goes to the superior operculum. So they simply label it as operculum. Now with the recent introduction of endoscopes, they further classified into segments. We need not bother about these terms. Just label it as roof. Anterior pillar, posterior pillar, floor. This is subiculum. Posterior pillar continues backwards as subiculum. Anterior pillar continues as funiculus. And this is fuses. Remember, subcochlear canal, in the modern literature, they labeled it as hypotympanic cells. Hypotympanic cell. The surgical importance is, most of the time, surgeon may think this as a scalar tympani and they pass the electrode into this subcochlear canal, SCC. This leads to Peters effects. So one should not insert into this. With the endoscopic anatomy, this structure became very clear. The mnemonic is, this is present between two F words. One is fused disc, F. Other is funiculus, F. Subcochlear, SCC, present between fused disc and funiculus. Never pass your electrode into this. This is a trap.
Sir, can you show me the previous diagram? On this bone, can you show these structures?
This one?
Yeah, on the end.
This one?
Yeah.
No, I will explain. I will show another diagram. This is old literature. At that time, only Professor Proctor, he published about fusions, but other authors, especially Cochlear reconstructions, has not given that much importance. With the recent introduction of endoscopic anatomy, that has come into lot of importance, and with the more and more difficult cases we are doing, then that importance has decayed. But I will explain another for clear cut pictures of the relationship. Opercula, anterior postcular, subicular, funicular fustis. And this is concomitata lateralis, concomitata medialis. That is tip superior to fustis, tip inferior to fustis. CI searches mistakenly pass easier and prodigal into this test CC. One should not done. That is a trap. Let us come to normal round in the night. See, this is technique. We don't want to use this foreign terminology. We simply use it as proof. Anterior pillar, posterior pillar, flow. Again, why we are getting so many shapes? I will explain now. We are getting so many shapes of round and round. Structures outside the nitinum chamber which enters. First, five parts we have to describe the whole round and round. The structures out, first one is structures outside the round window. Exostosis. This exostosis may prevent your entry. That is exostosis. Hydrocular pattern. This is outside the round window. See, tubular pattern is almost touching this. And tubercle, prebicle. So these three structures are outside the round window niche, which may hinder your passage of air. Round window niche variations of its gradient. Why we are getting so many shapes? I will explain. See, this is roof, red is floor, anterior pillar and posterior pillar. Narrow niche. So this whole thing became narrow. So this is narrow. Again, the roof. Came down, that is segment came down. That's why we are getting comma shaped round in the right. Anterior pillar, there are some trabeculae. There are some trabeculae. That's why we are getting the anterior septum. And bony membrane, this is bony membrane. And open fundus. Again, this is another trap. Open fundus, that means open floor. In simple terminology, you may pass electrode into this. So this is another trap. The first trap is subcochlear canal, and again this is another trap. Actual skeleton is here. So round window grids. This was done by our Indian authors only. I forgot his name. He's Professor of Chandigarh, he graded into four grades. Grade 1, more than 50% of the round window is visible. Round window like visible to the surgeon through a wide posterior tympanotomy was graded into four types. Grade 1, more than 50%. Grade 2, less than 50%. Grade 3, only glimpse of round window is seen. Grade 4, round window membrane not visible. Some surgeons they call it as rotations of the cochlea. Whatever it may be, they classified into four grades. So from their study it is grade 3 is more common. So accordingly the surgery. Grade 1, direct round window membrane insertion. In grade 2, just drill the round window niche. Grade 3, drill the round window niche and crista fenestri. Grade 4, cochleostomies. Relation of the osteospirellum and lamina and round window niche. Next is peri round window area. This one I will explain later. Peri round window area, fustis and subcochlear canal. So this one. Fustis, there are type clear fustis and type clear fustis. Type clear fustis directly pointing towards skeletal canal.
That is type A fustis. Type B fustis is, it is pointing down. The two types of fustis are there. This is fustis. Very important. As a cochlear implant surgeon, when you are unable to identify the round window, this is an important landmark. You can appreciate the task and all.
This is type 2 in this case.
Yes. So this is fustis. Concomerator, medialis. Concomerator, lateralis. So here it is round window. This is subcochlear canal, tunnel, or canal. These are all the German languages.
So in this
simply we remember as roof, anterior, posterior pillar, floor. Sir.
Where will you make a cochleostomy in this particular case?
Yes. So this is, 7 is the round window membrane.
Yeah.
Make a plus in your brain. This is anterior inferior. Again, we know inferior cochleostomy. See here, round window, fused this, scarlet. Like this. Scarlet tympani from round window goes below. It is not straight. That is the reason why Dr. Satish Jain advocates direct inferior cochleostomy and direct trajectory to scarlet tympani.
Yes. Because that hook region will be...
He is eliminating the hook region. That hook region I will explain later. See, this is my dissection bone. This is fustis. See, in this... See here, this bone is very thick. This is called crista fenestra. I will explain later that. This bone is very thick. This is inferior cochleostomy. This is crista fenestra. I will explain that. Fustis variation. Again, Professor Proctor, so many labels. Fustis. That means it is not a simple rod. Fustis is simple name. Its meaning is rod. Fustis reticulocelularis. Fustis dentis. So many names are there. Lattus, pisiform, triangularis, acrid, whatever it may be. What you have to know is, it is also again different shapes. Duplex, level letters, subcochlear canal. CSHS mistakenly passed here and put it into this one. Previously they used to call this as hypotympanism. It is well described in the literature by so many surgeons. This is fustis. This one is SCC. You should not pass into this. Again, this subcochlear tunnel is graded into 3 based on the cap. So this is going up to vicus apex. This is type A. It is not that much dematized, type B. If it is not there, it is type C. Whatever it may be, it is a trap. Please remember that it is a trap. Is going up to petrous apex, infracochlear area. With the endoscope, the petrous apex cholesteromas, now surgeons are moving through this infracochlear approach. But some surgeons, they don't accept it. It is a separate topic. So this is the endoscope. The future we may use 1mm endoscopes, less than 1mm endoscopes to this transdiplanic also. This is osseous spiral lamella, base lamella, membrane and spiral lamella. I will explain that. This red dot part is crista fenestra. I will explain that. This is subcochlear canal. See this one. This one. Round window membrane, the fourth part. See, the round window membrane and the operculum is explained in the previous literature as goes to go superior heart and enter inferior part. Round window also goes to the superior round window membrane and to the inferior round window membrane. The postural superior round window membrane is lesser in size, roughly it is 3:4, cuts by 3 quadrants, here 4 quadrants. This red color is the posterior superior round window membrane, this is and inferior round window. This inferior thickened 1 mm thickened bone is called crista fenestrae. Inferior bone which gives origin of this round window membrane is called crista semilunaris, and this, there is a fibrous band in there. Again, the remaining part is again there is horizontal part, vertical part, not much significance, but as a CA surgeon when you are dealing with crista semilunaris, if you know it is better, and this is fustis, and this fustis if you follow, it will reach to crista semilunaris. So inferiorly crista semilunaris, sorry, posteriorly crista semilunaris, inferiorly it is the crista fenestrae. So in round window insertion, what is creating problem is this crista fenestrae. This is one of the occlusion. Okay. Posterior superior round window membrane and the inferior round window. Posterior superior round window membrane and the inferior round window. Say old literature, operculum and membrane has same name. This simplified. This posterior superior, close to osseous parallel. I will explain that. Vertical portion. They call another name is horizontal. Why they are calling horizontal? I will explain. Again, it is vertical. This is membranous port entry to the scalar tympani. Vertical portion. This vertical portion is and inferior. Roughly 3:4. This one. So in a sagittal section, this vertical part of the round window membrane, hardened part of the round window. Here osseous spiral lamina, primary osseous spiral lamina, secondary osseous spiral lamina, whatever it may be. This horizontal round window membrane, that means post to superior round window membrane, just 1 mm or less than 1 mm with the osseous spiral. This is in another section. The red one is post to superior round window membrane, that is horizontal, this is vertical and the inferior round window. This red one is red, green one is green, and the inferior is this, posterior superior is this, posterior superior is osseous spiral. That is the reason why Dr. Bhattacharya is saying when you are drilling the operculum, better not to drill the posterior superior part of the operculum. The reason is you may injure this posterior superior round window membrane. When you are drilling, you may not notice also. So this posterior superior round window membrane is very near to the posterior superior operculum. Not only that, it becomes a grade 4 coplear trauma. I will explain what is grade 4. It induces the osseous spiral lamina. When injury of osseous spiral lamina happens, it is grade 4 coplear trauma. This is osseous spiral lamina, posterior superior overhang, this is the subiculum and this is the aortic capsule. There is a small gap, this is less than 1 mm. So when you are, that is the reason why when you are making a hole in the round window insertion, you have to, you should not disturb this one. You have to make, that is, antero inferior round window membrane only, you have to make a incision. So this is osseous spiral lamina. As it goes turns, basal turn, when it turns, basal turn, it becomes like gradually it falls. Like this falls like this, osseous spiral lamina. It almost becomes parallel to the vertical part of the facial nerve. Osseous spiral lamina, at entry point, posterior superior is like this. See, when it's going down, it declines. This is like this. A, B, C. A, B, C. A, B, C.
kidney structure. Crista fenestre, crista semilunaris, and fibrous gland. Now in this diagram, I removed the round and numbers there. What is there? See, in the initial diagram, we made a plus. Antero inferior, antero superior, postero superior, postero inferior quadrants. So, what are the vital structures in each quadrant? Postero superior quadrant, there is modulus. If you injure that, that is great for injury. Antero superior, osseous parallelogram, basal membranes, parallelogram, complex. Again, it becomes great for injury. You have to make membrane rupture, that is vertical part of the round membrane here only. So same zone is antero inferior. This is the reason why we are making cochleostomies in the crista fenestre. Marginal cochleostomy, antero inferior cochleostomy, inferior cochleostomy, all the three are crista fenestre only. This crista fenestre is not just a small one membrane, it is a triangular part also. It has both the lengths. This thickness and length, I will explain another diagram. So that is the reason why you have to come like this. From posterior superior, your trajectory should be from posterior superior to antero inferior. Your direct trajectory. Posterior superior round window. See how it is closely attached to the osseous parallelogram. Red part, osseous parallelogram. The screw is osseous parallelogram. A, B, C. A, B, C. Here it is vertical, gradually it becomes horizontal. So never make superior cochleostomy. You will injure the osseous parallelogram. That is great for hook region. This, to make simplify, this is plaster tip. Let us consider it as round window. White pepper, osseous spiral lamina, basilar membrane, spiral lamina. From posterior superior, we are spreading it. So, osseous spiral lamina, basal, this is right here. Basal membrane, spiral ligament, from posterior superior. So, never make cochleostomy to the posterior superior area. And to superior area. Same. See here, this is round window. This is round window. Round window. Basilar membrane, spiral ligament, crista fenestre. This part is crista fenestre. Okay, it is coming from posterior superior. Never injure that. This is the left ear. You have to orient your brain both right and left. This is osseous parallelogram, spiral ligament. This is left. Both going into antero superior part. So, when I am describing, the old literature says simple terminology, postero superior, antero inferior. Simple. And I am describing even further. I am classifying them as quadrants. Plus. Now the hook region. See, this is crista semilunaris. This is crista fenestre. And the starting initial point of the vesicle, all the three becomes the hook region. All the three. This is the reason some surgeons they don't advocate round window insertion. So when you are inserting, you insert directly, you are hitting this osseous spiral lamina. The insertion itself you are making great for injury. You are getting resistance to the very insertion itself. Region, the narrowest point of crista fenestre, crista semilunaris, an initial term of osseous parallelogram is called hook region. So this is crista fenestre. This one is Christopher Street. This is obstructive. This is old terminology. Simple. This is simple. And this is triangle. This is not just a. See, this is when we are seeing through the facial recess approach. What we see is only this one. This one is this one. This A only. We are seeing only A only. Again, this is B. Height is also there. So that is the reason why when you are drilling inferior papillostomy, you have to drill more. This much thickness you have to drill. So inferior papillostomy simply won't open. It takes some time. So because the thickness is very heavy. So even the anterior inferior papillostomy also sometimes it takes a lot of time. So marginal papillostomy, anterior inferior papillostomy, inferior papillostomy, all the three we are doing in Christopher state. This is how we see through the facial recess approach. The inferior part is Christopher state. The posterior is Christopher similis. And now I am using the words quadrants plus posterior, superior is modulus. Here's for engine. You should not pass here. You should not injure. When you are drilling this crystal semilunar, you should not injure this area. Your drill should not go posto superior, plus shape. Anterior, superior, osseous parallel. Only you have to drill the crystal finished rate. If you are unable to pass the electrode, you have to drill the crystal finished rate. That is marginal papillostomy. Slowly, slowly you drill it, slowly you suck it. Drill, suck. Drill, suck. The bone should not go into the scalar tympani. Because it hindrances the electrical transmission of this array, the spiral area. So this is the outer wall of the vessel door. This red is crystal illustrate. This red is crystal illustrate. See, the electrode array is going into the anterior inferior movement of membrane. When you face difficulty, you can drill this crystal semilunaris also. Even if you are unable to pass after drilling this crystal semilunaris, you can make marginal papillostomy. Never push, it will kill. Marginal papillostomy. See, marginal papillostomy in crystal finished tray. And inferior papillostomy, inferior papillostomy, again in the crystal finished tray. And inferior papillostomy, inferior papillostomy. This is direct trajectory. Satish Jain advocates this only. He stopped doing anything. He stopped doing ground under membrane. He stopped doing anterior inferior papillostomy. He is doing only inferior papillostomy. He read all the literature. He decided inferior papillostomy is the best. So this is inferior papillostomy. See this thickness. How much I did. This whole thing is crystal fenestrate. This thickness is this thickness. So that's why it took a lot of time for me to make inferior papillostomy. This thickness is crystal fenestrate. See how much thick it is. Amount of drilling is so much in inferior papillostomy. This is the experimental lab in my. So superior papillostomy, induced osseous parallel nerve, grade 4 injury. Never do that one. See the again the relation, old literature also clear cut explained. They have done ample cadaver studies, ample studies. Osseous parallel are reaching. Post to superior, according to old literature nomenclature, post to superior, overhand and post to superior round window. So number two, superior papillostomy. See this papillostomy, round window membrane. this is inferior or little bit more here, it is inferior tropius. Now, let us go to the embryology. This is roof, this is anterior pillar, posterior pillar, floor, round window, make it. Embryology. First, roof, anterior pillar, posterior pillar develops. Slowly, slowly, this small bone at the floor develops. That is crista semilunaris. This fustis is going and reaching this crista semilunaris. See the fustis in adult. This is embryology, parietal embryology. Crista semilunaris. So when you are unable to pass this electrode, try to drill this part, crista semilunaris. Even if then you cannot pass, do marginal copulostomy. So Satish said, don't want all this headache. He wants to do direct inferior copulostomy. That means he is escaping hook region. Whole hook region he is escaping. And moreover that he is getting direct trajectory. See, this is subiculum. Here in the initial diagram, subiculum. Why is it subiculum? See with the endoscopic anatomy. Goes to superior area. That is the reason why osseous spinal angle attached to the subiculum and posterior pillar. So when you are seeing the same structure inside the cochlea, from inside the cochlea, this is round window micae, that is black area is outside. We are seeing through the skeletal impari. Observe here important structure, cochlear aqueduct. It is just behind the crista semilunaris. Histology. This red one is crista semilunaris. Just behind is cochlear aqueduct. So when you are passing electrode, your crista semilunaris is hindering. So we have to do this crista semilunaris. This is osseous spinal lamina and round window membrane. Actually, this round window membrane described in the literature is posterior superior round window membrane. So based on this is around 1 mm. That means this 1 mm is skeletal impari here. So that is the reason why Prahlasa said never or better not to drill the posterior superior operculum so that it will injure the posterior superior round window membrane, so that it will injure the osseous spinal lamina, becomes grade 4 cochlear trauma. Round window grades, 4 grades, profession already explained. Again, so when you have observed, when you are doing this facial research approach, when you observed all these things, in brain you have to calculate the grades based on these funny findings. What are the structures outside the round window micae? Round window micae mediations, hook region, based on all those things you have to grade. Intracochlear trauma grades. Grade 1. Just see, this is osseous spinal lamina, basal membrane, spiral. With electrode is just kinking. Grade 2, top. Grade 3, electrode entered into the scala, tempering. Grade 4, osseous spinal lamina injured. Grade 4, osseous spinal lamina is grade 4. Modulus, again grade 4. Striae vascularis injury, when it passed here, above, it injured this. All three are grade 4. So, with the latest description in class, when you go anterior superior, you will injure this osseous spinal lamina, grade 4. Posterior superior, you will injure the modulus in plus. So these are just thinking, tall, scala tympani insertion, and this one osseous spinal lamina, grade 4. say radiology. In detail, HRCT explanation is given by Dr. Satish Jain. You can do that one. He is my guru. In detail, it is there in YouTube. This whole presentation is there in skullbase360.in. If you click that one, it is excellent presentation by Dr. Satish Jain. Clapia and HRCT Department Dislodge Custody. So, pars inferior, pars ascendens, pars superior, pars descendens. Okay, na? And the modulus. Now let us come to the post operative. You can observe the same. The identification of segments 1 and 4, the modulus is located deeper than the bony surface. So this modulus is still deeper. This is histological study. Similarly, you can correlate the HRCT, post op HRCT. So when you are observing 1 and 4, when you are appreciating, when you are assessing the one electrode and fourth part of the electrode, your modulus is not seen. When you are appreciating 1, 3, 5, your modulus is seen in CT scan. This is 1, this is 3, this is 5. Similarly, visualizing the segments of 1 and 3 and the modulus, 1 and 3 and modulus, modulus is clearly seen. The cut goes through the modulus. Visualization of the beginning of the tube, that is pars ascendens electrode, your modulus is not seen. So this is histological correlation with the HRCT imagination. Radiology is very explained by Dr. Satish Jain. A few points I am explaining. See, this result, when you are doing the best view in any HRCT is axial. When you are coming from superiorly also, you will see the basal term. When you are coming, reaching the inferior also, you will see the basal term. So what happens is, the middle term is present in the lap of the basal term. Superior term present in the lap of the middle term. We may think that superior term is seen in the uppermost section of the HRCT. It is not. The uppermost section of the HRCT, you will see the basal term only. It is very obvious that inferior term, at the inferior section we see the basal term. But we make a mistake at the uppermost section, we may think that it is superior term. Actually, it is not. All ecological studies and all cadaver studies is clearly superior term present in the lap of middle term. Middle term present in the lap of the basal term. This is radiology, everyone knows this. Special research scientist, Rational. Rational variations. Clearly,
we will restrict the rough window and just think this.
Almost complete.
Okay.
I will just give the links. This is facial variations, YouTube, you can watch it. I clearly explained this facial. Remember, we are doing congenital malformations. Always remember this facial variations. Everything is explained in the YouTube video. You can clearly watch that. Trajectory of cochlear implant array. See, the media, we are coming from superior. I am going like this. And the inferior cochlear like this. Round window, this is the track. And the inferior, like this. Inferior cochlear implant. See, that is the reason why Satish Jain sir is saying this is the best. No angulation at all. That microscopic details, rings are present at the modulus area. This one, posterior spiral beam, black arrows, white arrow, rings are present, modular rings, rings are present. When you are passing the electrode, whenever you get a resistance, slowly weight, when you are passing also, push, weight, and then push. Don't directly push. Whenever you get a resistance, a little bit backwards, and rotate, and then push. The reason is, hit, you may induce these vessels. Spiral ligament also. This is color depending only. There is beam in this spiral ligament. See how porous it is.
So the electron will pass into this spiral elements. So whenever you get a resistance, little bit backwards, weight. Weight is very important. You weight. And then rotate in the insert. See the spiral ganglion relation. This is related to stellar temporary. And the beam is there, modular beam. So now this is the very original research by Professor Kao. What he says is, he advocates single channel. The reason is, all these hair cells are lost, and he says these dendrites also lost. Only remaining is spiral ganglion. Then the question is, what is question? Main question is, when the dendrites are lost, why we need multi-channel? Actually, we are stimulating the spiral ganglion cells. So there is no point that in the multi-channel we are stimulating the dendrites. They are checked. So actually, in so many cadaver studies, what is observation is there is no dendrites. That is the reason why he advocates image. Close, close, sir. Next, I will explain.